hinged as much about, you know, that that opening from those different counties. It's what are those mechanisms that we have in place to really control spread? You can control spread while opening the economy. You just have to make sure that you're doing it well. And the community has to be invested in that process of doing it well. It's really incumbent upon everybody.
Do you have a sense of when St. Louis area hospitals will be able to resume elective surgeries?
A very difficult question to answer. And so in some ways it mirrors sort of the reopening of the economy. So of course we want to see the number of COVID patients in our hospitals coming down at a steady rate as well. We want to make sure that our workforce is going to be able to handle more patients coming in. We want to make sure that we have personal protective equipment because as you can imagine, when you're doing surgeries, that takes up personal protective equipment. And so you want to make sure that you have enough supplies in order to take care of all of those. And then lastly, on the testing front, you want to make sure that you're able to test people as well that are coming in for things like, you know, knee surgeries and stuff like that, because you don't want to bring somebody who could be an asymptomatic person who's infected into the operating room and potentially expose, you know, the workforce. So there's just like reopening the economy, there's a lot of building blocks that need to be put in place before we'd feel comfortable by saying, yes, let's start doing elective surgeries.
Are there regional projections for what could happen to our COVID caseload as restrictions are either lifted or loosened?
The question really isn't about the restriction. The question is about transmission. So as I mentioned previously, you can reduce the restrictions if you do a very good job of keeping transmissions low. And so so that's really the question. So if we went back to the way life was before COVID started, with absolutely no social restrictions, you know, people interacting, you know, large gatherings, things like that, absolutely that will drive our case rate up. No question about that. So the answer to that question is really dependent upon what sort of mitigation efforts do we have in place to keep the transmission number low. If you can do that through the public health measures and through all of the social distancing rules, then it is possible to open, you know, more of the economy and more of society. But the key is to keep the transmission rate low.